I'm Kathyayini Chamraj. I'm Executive Trustee of CIVIC Bangalore. CIVIC stands for Citizens Voluntary Initiative for the City of Bangalore. CIVIC was started in 1992 as a group of concerned citizens who were bothered about the way Bangalore was growing. Bangalore was growing very fast at that time, but the citizens had no say in the way the city was developing. It was transforming from a pensioner's paradise into something that they had not imagined. So at the same time, the constitutional amendment, the 74th constitutional amendment or Nagarpalika Act came into force, and that gave the impetus for CIVIC to work on that as the prime issue. So the Nagarpalika Act had the same objective that CIVIC was started with. That is to bring in greater people's participation, to bring in more transparency and accountability in the urban governance. And since those objectives matched very well with the CIVIC's objectives, CIVIC first of all held a big conference where they had all the stakeholders of Bangalore coming and discussing about the 74th constitutional amendment and how it could be implemented in Bangalore. And we gave several recommendations to the government about how the conformity legislation should be legislated in Karnataka. And a lot of thought went into bringing people's participation into that legislative framework, because we felt that there has to be an institutionalized platform where citizens can participate in the governance of their area. And then since ward committees were part of the 74th constitutional amendment, we gave several recommendations to the government on how the ward committees should be constituted, how they should function, so that there is genuine people's participation. Of course, several of our recommendations were not implemented, but CIVIC was also instrumental in getting the ward committees constituted in Bangalore. And later on, we even studied how the ward committees are functioning. And one of the objectives of the 74th Amendment is to decentralize governance and to make the municipal council a local self-government which handles 18 issues which have been devolved to local government through the 74th Amendment. And one of the issues that has been devolved is that of urban water supply and management. And so we initially were working with a number of residents' welfare associations for several years, but later on, around 2005, we realized that the city is growing in a way which is creating a lot of disparity between the urban poor and the more affluent sections in the city. So we thought our focus should be more on the urban poor and their rights, their basic rights. So we started working on five basic rights of the urban poor, that is the right to food, right to water, right to health, education and livelihood. And so right to water was one of the areas we chose. Initially we were working in two wards. One is Devasantra ward and one is Sagayapuram ward. And there we were able to use certain strategies to institutionalize citizen participation to get their grievances redressed. And in the field of water, our strategy was to first get the citizen charter of the Bangalore Water Supply and Sewerage Board through the use of right to information. So we asked them for the citizen charter through RTI, and then we empowered the citizens of these two wards with knowledge about the citizen charter. For instance, nobody knows that the BWSP has a mandate to supply tanker water free of charge when they are unable to supply minimum quantity of water to the residents of an area. So when the slum dwellers did not get minimum supply of water, they used to just go hunting for water and pay much more than an affluent citizen to get a potable drinking water, up to rupees 2 per pot or rupees 5 per pot. So we educated them that you don't have to go and buy water when you don't get BWSP water. it is in the citizen charter that BWSD should supply free water to you. So we empower them with knowledge about who is your local water engineer of the BWSD. And anytime you don't get the minimum supply, you should always call him and ask for a free tanker. And we educated them about the grievance redressal mechanisms that exist within the BWSD, whom to approach, where to go, where is your local office. So basically we did not believe in supplanting government work. We did not believe in because they don't have water, we supply the water. That was not our approach. We wanted to make the government or the agency deliver what they are supposed to deliver as per their citizen charter. So we have been empowering citizens to demand their rights. So we want to make the government do what it is supposed to do, because after all these are fundamental rights and these are fundamental duties of the government towards the citizens. So once the people are educated about their rights, as far as the Bangalore water supply and sewerage board is concerned, we organize grievance redressal meetings. If the BWSD is not holding them, we hold local area level grievance redressal meetings where we invite the water engineer or the executive engineer of that area, and we make the residents present their grievances to them. One of the grievances may be, see, our borewell is not working or your water is not being supplied, and so you are not sending us a free water tanker, so please do send that. So that way we make the citizens demand their right at this grievance redressal meeting. And if a borewell is dysfunctional, then we get them to ask for the borewell to be repaired. And so the executive engineer or the assistant engineer, he makes a very commitment. He says, okay, from now on I will send a free water tanker or I will set the borewell right. Then we record all that and submit it to them as a report of the grievance meeting, and we wait for them to take action. But if they don't take action, then we use right to information to ask for the action taken report on our submitted grievances. So then they have to take action and come back to us with the action taken. So that way we find that we are able to get number of grievances redressed. But we have not been doing only the local area work like this. From the experience that we get at this local area, we see that maybe the wall man is not functioning as he should, or there is a problem within the system itself that is preventing the slum dwellers from getting their rightful amount of water. Then we collect, we even do action research surveys, and we did one survey of 23 slums in Bangalore just to portray to the water board what is the situation in the slums. If you look at the overall city development plan of Bangalore, the BWSD may have claimed that they have covered BBMP 100% with water, but that does not mean that every slum really has piped connection or that they are getting their regular supply of water. So through our survey of 23 slums, we were able to show BWSD that the slums are really being deprived of their fundamental right to water, and various problems associated with that. So, and when we do a survey like this, we present it to the highest officials in the BWSD, and this is a city level meeting that we call it a public hearing, so that we have a panel of judges also who are experts who give their comments about what our survey findings have said, and we request the highest person in the BWSD, maybe the chairman or the chief engineer, to respond to those findings. So this way we intend to do advocacy, do our action research, and bring systemic change within the system. So two areas which we have identified for which we are doing city level advocacy is that there is no proper grievance redressal system within the BWSD to hold local area meetings and resolve the grievances of the citizens. So we
we gave a memorandum to the BWSSP saying that you should institutionalize a grievance redressal system. And one other lacuna that we observed through our city level survey is that there are no institutionalized participatory mechanisms for the people to interact with BWSSP. Like in other fields, like in the education department, there may be a school development and monitoring committee where the local people are represented, and through that committee they advocate and bring about systemic changes. In the ration shop scenario, there may be a vigilance committee which is supposed to monitor the functioning of the ration shop. In the hospital, public hospital, there may be an Arogya Raksha committee which has community members on that committee who can monitor the functioning at the local level. We found that BWSSP does not have this institutional mechanism, so we advocated for that, and several initial meetings have been held to bring in such a community participation platform where citizens can interact with BWSSP. The other area is that they don't have a real urban poor policy for water. BWSSP does not have an urban poor policy through which they say, yes, these are the rights and this is what we commit to providing. So we are negotiating, or we are discussing with a number of civil society actors who work on water to come up with a draft urban poor policy which we will present to BWSSP, and through several discussions they can bring about the urban poor policy. So that all slums are, get as much water or as much as good service as the more affluent sections get. So what CIVIC has been working for is that through information, we bring about transparency in the working of the BWSSP, and by holding those grievance redressal meetings, we are making the officials accountable. And we are striving for the people's participation through institutionalized mechanisms. And we are doing advocacy for policy change so that, there are systemic changes brought about to really serve the urban poor. Now we would request public to support this work of CIVIC, because we are trying to improve governance systems and not supplement or supplant government service generally. And I think this is very essential, because unless governance is improved, we cannot get rid of the corruption that is pervading in the entire system. And our focus is on that. So we would like a corruption-free governance which will enable people to access their rights without any hitch or intermediate problems. We would like donors and even individual donors and agencies, funding organizations, to support our work through financial contribution so that we can continue this focus on governance and rights-based approach of empowering the urban poor.